apparatus, and you've got to make it stop. And you've got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all.
Welcome one and welcome all to the Daily Mayhem Report. Good Lord, thank God it's Friday. We'll start off as always on going back into time a little bit. Let's see what happened. It was this day, February 10th, 1996, Kasparov versus computer chess match. Well, big deal. Okay, good Lord, getting back to today, things that matter across the board. The Dow Jones, the NASDAQ, the S&P, 10-year bonds, GE, all down. The Dow was down almost 90 points, NASDAQ just over 23, and the S&P's third. Good Lord. Okay, what else is going on in the world? Well, let's start off with one of my favorite subjects, Obama bullshit. I've really had enough of this guy, and now his wife's getting on my nerves, too. Let's see here. First headline, Yahoo News from AP sources. Obama retreats on contraception, shifts burden from religious groups to insurers. See, this guy can't, whether he's right or wrong, okay, at this point, it's gone so far beyond that. He can't even hold a line. He can't even make a decision and stand on it. He tells you whatever you want to hear. Did I mention he's an illegal alien? Okay, moving on. More Obama bullshit. In this is not good either. Ruling the whole world with an iron fist. New Iran sanctions. President signs executive order citing NDAA authority. This from the New American. Once again, the provision of the National Defense Authorization Act is being cited by Washington as jurisdiction for a new policy position. Listing section 1245 of the NDAA, on Monday, President Barack Obama signed an executive order imposing a roster of new sanctions on the government of Iran, including the Central Bank of Iran. You see this? You just write something down on a sticky note now, and that gives you control of any place on the planet? No. We did not give him that authority. American people did not give him the authority to ostracize any nation he chose by putting a note on a sticky pad. No, Mr. President. No, you need to go. And his wife now. Did you hear this headline? I don't have the link in front of me, but I'm going to rant about it anyway. It's on my YouTube video if you need to get credit for the post. Michelle Obama, watching her husband rule the world, the whole globe, with an iron fist, do anything he wants, not even go to court. So now she's going and making all the military, 1,100 military bases, they got to change their diet now. She thinks she knows better than they do on how to eat. Our American soldiers, disrespectful, control, good Lord. All right, I better move on because I'm going to get upset. Let's talk a little more about the economy. This coming out of the BBC. We know Greece is critical. Athens clashes in Greece over Greece Eurozone austerity deal. Again, this was from the BBC, and it's saying that protesters have clashed with police in the Greek capital, Athens, amid anger over fresh austerity measures approved under pressure from Eurozone ministers. Demonstrators threw rocks and petrol bombs at police, who responded with tear gas. The clashes came after trade unions began a 48-hour strike. Parliament is expected to vote on a package of cuts and reforms on Sunday. So you see, we're talking about our money. The whole world is blowing up. It's ridiculous. A little bit more stuff coming in about the economy in relation to the trade deficit. This in Yahoo News. As soon as the page decides to load, this again was from the AP and Yahoo News. Trade deficit widens to $48.8 billion in December, pushing deficit for 2011 to $558 billion. You see, 2011 is dead and gone. We licked our wounds. We thought we knew what we were up against, and wham! There you go. another 48.8 billion on top of what we already had stuffed up our wazoo. Good Lord. And one more thing here. Oh, what is this? This from the Extinction Protocol. Market retreats on news of downgrade of 34 Italian banks. Stocks added to losses Friday on track to logging their worst session this year after stalled debt negotiations in Greece. Some disappointing economic news and reports that S&P downgraded a handful of Italian banks. In the latest round of disappointment from Eurozone ratings agency, S&P downgraded 34 of 37 Italian banks. Oh, yo, no, Kevin, everything is fine. There's nothing to worry about. Okay, moving on. News about our contorting Earth. Indonesia, again, this from the Extinction Protocol. Mount Lukan volcano unleashes 2-kilometer-high ash cloud. This has been restless. A restless volcano in northern Indonesia erupted Friday, spewing clouds of ash as high as 2 kilometers into the sky, the country's National Disaster Management Agency said. The authorities are warning residents to stay away from the volcano. You think? Oh, okay, we got a volcano spewing out ash and gas. We're not going to run right up there, are we? I guess maybe some would. I don't know. I've lost hope as far as intelligence levels anymore. Okay, more stuff about the contorting Earth, again from the Extinction Protocol. Philippines Mount Canlaun volcano summit closed after large cracks found near the crater. Good Lord. They've been caused by Monday's 6.9 magnitude earthquake, and that's a wonderful. Volcanoes all over the place. The earth is contorting and twisting. Now, moving on, some more killing. News about our warring world. This, I love the Extinction Protocol. You got to subscribe to them. 60 killed in shelling as government renews bombardment of Homs hospitals overwhelmed. This is in Syria. Syrian rights activists say government forces have bombarded the rebellious central city of Homs for a 6 day, killing at least 60 people and leaving makeshift hospitals overwhelmed as divided world powers struggle to end the violence. Okay. Well, you could take this one of two ways, and we just don't even know anymore. You know, other reports coming in that Iran has sent 15,000 soldiers into Syria as well. We don't know any of this. Is this propaganda? Did this really happen? You know, I really encourage, this is something I'm going to give a shout out while we have all these listeners, that I am here near this computer even when we're not broadcasting live 99% of the time. It's a perfect opportunity to get people from around the world with breaking urgent news that's going on to get a hold of me directly. Within 5 minutes, we can have you on air, and there's always at least 2,000 or 3,000 people listening in, even. And with some promotions, a good chance we could quickly, in 5 to 15 minutes, get 10,000 people listening to an urgent report. If we can get that going and get real humans to tell us what the hell is going on in this world, because we can't trust even this Extinction Protocol, great resource, but they don't scrutinize everything and check all you know, somebody puts in a blog. It goes out in front of thousands of people, and the sheep are steered. And that's how it happens. Okay, moving on. Weather, wicked and wild. Afghanistan, first, hit with the heaviest snows in 15 years. 20 children die in a cold snap. More than 20 children have recently died due to the cold weather in Kabul, which the Afghan capital has been experiencing its worst cold snap and heaviest snows in 15 years. The National Weather Center said on Wednesday, this again, Extinction Protocol, more weather all over the place. Europe continues to suffer through the coldest February in 26 years. Europe's record freezing temperatures have claimed hundreds of lives, snarled traffic, and trapped tens of thousands of residents in remote villages across Serbia and Romania. It's the worst cold snap to happen in February in 26 years, George Mueller, a forecaster at Point Carbon, told Reuters. It was in 1986 when we had the last similarly severe cold weather in February, he said. This is an instance, this big blocking of cold air seemed to influence the way the winds behaved rather than the other way around. Yeah, well, we know the whole climate everywhere is changing. Things are getting very, very wild. A little bit more here. More news about Europe. Death toll from European deep freeze hits 460 as the Danube River freezes over. Okay, that when things like that happen, people, you got to wake up. Okay, it's not normal. It's not fine. It's ridiculous. Now this news about our toxic world. More birds dying. 600 birds found dead in Christchurch, being blamed on botulism. Christchurch City Council is investigating the death of more than 600 birds found along the banks of oxidation ponds at the city's wastewater treatment plant. It was working with National Institute of Water and Atmospheric Research and Fish and Game to determine how they died. Dead birds have also been found in other wetlands east of the city. The council says initial diagnosis indicates the birds died from avian botulism, a natural phenomena. Listen to me. It's not a natural phenomena for 600 birds to suddenly drop dead of anything, okay? Unless there's been major gun blast into the air to skeet shooting event. Now, come on. There's nothing normal about that at all. Good Lord. I just don't get it. I really don't. And now, vile viruses, pestilence watch, fears ignited in Vietnam after H5N1 mutation discovered. Vietnam is at high risk of a large-scale outbreak of bird flu without drastic preventative measures in the near future, the County Department of Animal Health has warned. Bird flu has been reported in 4 communities in 3 provinces. Now, listen, I'm going to stop right there, because, again, I don't know. This probably is going on. Wasn't it just a little while ago we found out that some scientists had mutated the avian flu to a degree that it would spread quickly through humans with, I think, a 60% kill rate, right? And then a few days later, we got Hillary Clinton warning of bioterroristic attacks are on the rise, or at a heightened level. And now we got, this is not the first report of H5N1. There's been major cullings going on all over the place because of this same thing. So, and we also found out for these cullings that the United States government paid those scientists to mutate that. So, what are we to think? We have all these dots, and it leads in a circle, and we're not supposed to think that anything is intentional. We're supposed to believe that everything is fine. 600 birds dropping dead. Vile diseases running rampant that we've paid to create. Oh, yeah, okay. If that's fine, then it is not fine. Doctors warn gonorrhea becoming untreatable due to antibiotic resistance. Again, the Extinction Protocol. Good Lord. This is coming out of North Carolina in this morning's NEJM. Physicians from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill and University of Washington, bluntly warn that gonorrhea at least threatens to become untreatable thanks to the acquisition of antibiotic resistance. Wonderful. Okay, one more disease that's permanent. It'll kill you, eat away at your body and your mind. And this, last but not least here, deadly Lassa fever outbreak kills 7 in Nigeria. 7 people have reportedly died in Taraba State following an outbreak of Lassa fever a couple of days ago. State Commissioner for Health, Prince Mustafa Haman Gabdo, confirmed this while briefing journalists in the state. The commissioner said 4 of the victims of the disease died at the Federal Medical Center, Jalingo. 1 died in the Government House Clinic, Jalingo. And 2 others who contracted the disease in Taraba State died in Gom State after traveling there for treatment. So, the epidemic is here, warns doctors. Lassa fever has over the years risen to be a quiet killer with victims oblivious of its presence. Cases of infection have been reported in Kano, Nasarawa, Jos, Ugan, Owerri, Ekpoma, and Bays. Now, if I mispronounce any of those, I apologize. But that's a bunch of places, okay? Let's just break it down. Deadly diseases, bunch of places. And you want to tell me everything is fine. Everything is not fine. Now, last but not least, the ever-lulzical hacker news. Oh, the hackers are always pulling something. One day a week, you don't hear anything from them. The rest of the week, they're going nuts. This one, hackers claim to compromise Intel's sensitive data. Wonderful. Security researcher under the name Weed Grower, or Exposed, has been on a roll since the start of 2012. He has ambushed huge sites such as AOL, NASA, Hotmail, MySpace, Xbox, US Bank, Yahoo, and Visa. He has also leaked sensitive data on most of these websites. Hackers today claiming that he compromised Intel's sensitive data like user base and credit cards. He found a way to expose sensitive data via the subscriber section on Intel.com, and he also has access to Intel.com database, which reveals credit card numbers, social security numbers, emails, passwords, and more. Weed Grower, or Exposed, has threatened that he's going to be leaking this soon if he doesn't get a response from Intel.com characters. And this is a quote from the hacker. I've got to give some applause to all those pseudo-security technicians out there. I cut Intel a break. I have access to a database and another vulnerability which enables the right to read user data. I will be gracious here and not spill the data, but I will provide screenshots to prove that I have access to credit card data and such. And there is an accumulation of partial numbers and data to prove that he has them. Okay. Hackers are running wild. One more thing here. This in relation to Apple. Apple supplier. Oh, here, load for me, Paige. Apple supplier Foxconn servers hack exposing vendor usernames and passwords. That's great. Apple supplier Foxconn is reportedly being hacked, exposing the usernames and passwords of companies, clients, and employees. Hacker group SwagSec just released a dump of Foxconn internal information, including a mail server login password dump and logins to various online procurement sites and intranets. We encourage media, security experts, and other interested individuals to explore our leaks. Foxconn did have appropriate firewall, but fortunately, to our intent, we were able to bypass it almost flawlessly. Of course, with funding ourselves, we did have our limitations, but with several hacking techniques employed in a couple of days' time, we were able to dump most of everything of significance, the hacker said. The group made a 6.04 megabyte file available earlier this evening, first on Demonoid, then on Pirate Bay, which purported to contain login password information for Foxconn email servers, intranets, and various other company-affiliated sites. That is the news. That is the mayhem. Good Lord, thank God it's Friday. Kick off your shoes. Relax.